Hi, this is Lokesh from Devil's Tattoos. I've been tattooing since 2003, so it's been almost 15, 16 years. And there's one question which I get a lot from almost all the clients who walk into the studio. And the question is, how should we choose our tattoo design? So today we would like to talk about the same thing, and I hope it'll help you choose your tattoo design better. So let's start. So our first advice to people is always choose a tattoo design which means something to you. You should not get any random design. So we get this from a lot of people that, people come over to us and say that I had got this tattoo done 5 years ago and now I've got bored of it. So why have they got bored of it? Because the tattoo that they chose did not mean anything to them. You know, if you get something which means something to you, be it related to your faith, your family, or anything, you know, your children's portrait, name, or, you know, something related to your religious faith or whichever God you believe in. If you get tattoos like these, which means something to you, you will never get bored of them because those things will mean something in your life. So that will be my first advice to people. Get something which means something to you. Don't get any random things done. Don't get a tattoo flash from the wall. Because you might eventually get bored of it. If you get something meaningful, you will never get bored of it. So the second thing I would like to talk about is the size and placement of the tattoo. Don't get a tattoo too small, but don't get a tattoo too big if it's your first tattoo. Because, you know, mostly people don't have the experience about the pain, although it doesn't pain that much, but still, to get the initial idea, you should get a tattoo which is small or medium in size. Also, another thing I would like to talk about the placement is, see, there are different kind of tattoos. If you're getting a symmetrical tattoo done, say a pair of wings, which goes like this, those kind of tattoos don't look good on the arm, because those tattoos are symmetrical, which means they're equal on both sides. So if you're getting a symmetrical tattoo, those kind of tattoos look good if they're at the center of your body, supposedly the back of the neck, the nape, or the chest, because, you know, they have a balance on both sides. And if you get a symmetrical tattoo on one side of the chest or on the bicep, it might look good, but it will always look good if it's aligned with the symmetry of your body. Another thing about the size is sometimes people get way too small tattoos done compared to the body part that they're getting a tattoo done. Like, we had clients in the past who wanted a 1x1 or 2x2, that this tiny Superman logo or something, and the guy is having 16 inches of bicep or 18 inches of bicep. So that tiny tattoo on this big area, it looks like a sticker. If you want a small tattoo only, it is always better to get it done at a smaller, at an area like a wrist. So wrist can fit a 2-inch tattoo pretty well. There is a little bit of space on the sides. It goes well on that area. Yeah, so if you get a small tattoo done at a huge area, like a small tiny flower or a Superman logo, for instance, as I told you, here on the bicep, and the bicep is this big and the tattoo is this small, it will look funny. Initially, you might like it because it's a new tattoo, you're excited, but it will look funny, and so I completely advise against it. The tattoo should be proportional to the area that you're getting the tattoo at. So the third thing I would like to talk about is that every artist doesn't specialize in everything. If you're looking for a particular kind of design, supposedly I would like to give you the instance of this, our studio. So we have 12 artists here. Everyone specializes in something different. I do mostly colored realism, colored portraits only. There are other guys who are doing black and gray portraits. Someone specializes in calligraphy. Someone specializes in traditional designs. Someone does, graphic novel sort of a work, like comic book characters sort of a work. Someone is good in cover-up, someone is good in freehand kind of tattooing, which flows according to the symmetry of your body. It should go with the style of the artist that you're choosing. You cannot go to an artist who does thick lines and traditional sort of work and ask him for a portrait. You might like his work in one style. He might be doing great Japanese work, but he might not be the best guy for portraits. And this is because, he's used to doing traditional thick lines, and portrait requires a lot of soft shading, almost like a pencil sketch. So both the styles are completely different, and the technical ability of the artist and the style is completely different. So please remember, every artist cannot do everything. Although they can do it, try, but there'll always be an artist who specializes in one thing So you should go to the specialist. So if you're looking for a portrait, go to the portrait specialist. If you're going for a line work or a geometry, look at the artist's line work. You know, go for someone who does clean lines. Every tattoo is different and every tattoo artist is different. So this is what I believe personally. You know, every artist cannot specialize in everything. So you should choose an artist who specializes in that particular style that you're looking for. So the fourth point, and a very important point I always stress on, is choose your own design. Don't ask your friends or your relatives or your family for help. We have had people who usually, you know, after choosing the design, they will be sending the final design on WhatsApp to their family group for approval, and then there'll be four or five inputs or maybe more. Add a wing to it, add a piece of diamond to it, or whatever people want to add. And then the client gets confused. So don't ask anyone. Get something that you like. We have had instances where someone is accompanied by four of their friends or three of their friends, and he's constantly asking their friends for the design. And when it's the turn of their friend to get tattooed, one of the friends who is advising right now, when it's his turn on the hot seat, he will ask the other three, and then they will advise him. And then when one of them is his turn to get tattooed. So I mean, basically what I mean to say is people don't choose their own design. They just keep on asking their friends who have no experience and knowledge about tattoos, or maybe even they have one or two tattoos, they are no experts. You know what you want much better than anyone else. So I think you should decide for your own. Don't ask 3, 4, 5 people. You ask 100 people, they will give you 100 different advices. You cannot incorporate everything in your tattoo. So please take decision for yourself, not only in tattooing, in life also. I always tell them, don't ask 100 people, because you know your capabilities, you know your preferences, you know your choices. Don't live with someone else's decisions, because you will definitely regret it later. Don't ask your friends, go for what you like. And last but not the least, always consult with your artist before you finalize the design, because sometimes what happens is people get this size of a tattoo with a fairy or an angel made, with all the clothes, all the jewelry, all the details, with the wings, but it will not be possible in this size, because after a few years, if the total body of the tattoo supposedly is this size, the face is gonna be more like a small coin, or even smaller than that in most cases. So you can imagine the eyes will be like two dots, or you know. So basically what I mean to say is, in this small tattoo, if you put so many details, it will get smudged in future, and after 5 years your tattoo might look like a blob of ink and nothing else. So consult your artist. If you have chosen a design which has so many details in it, the artist will advise you for the right size. Don't imagine that you will get four things or five super realistic things in this size and they will stay like that forever. It might look good at that moment. You might have seen your friend getting that tattoo and it's looking good right now, but after few years it might smudge. So always listen to the artist. The artist will tell you the right placement and the right size for the tattoo. If you are limited to the budget or limited to the size that you want, you don't want it bigger than this, then the artist will reduce some details, so the tattoo's longevity, the life of the tattoo will be much longer. The tattoo after 20 years will also look the same, and it will not smudge. So always consult the artist before finalizing on the design. They will help you with the right size and placement. Yeah, so those are the things you should take care of before choosing your tattoo design. If you have any other query, please feel free to call us or email us. The info will be given at the end of the video. You can see our new work on Instagram or our website, which we keep on updating regularly. So make sure you go to our Instagram and see the work, and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, because we'll be putting more informative videos on this channel soon. So yeah, thank you.